Hi, coach.
Hi, how are you? How are you?
I'm good, coach.
Okay. So, did you send this video to coaches? What link.
Link I will share in the chat right now.
Okay. So, what I want to ask you, we can also share this what we have. For example, from topics, this briefing from session, and we can share them. This video, what you also prepare and everything.
Yeah, we will share.
Okay. This is important, you know, because they need to have this with them. And also, we need to keep this with us to make something like a library, you know, for BFI. Okay?
Yeah, coach.
Okay. You will tell me when we can start, yes?
Yeah.
Okay. You know what will be good? This chat what participants send is almost full screen, you know, so it's bother, I cannot see my phone.
Wait, I will not.
You know this chat what they send, this.
Now you will not.
You need this good evening coach from Calcutta or something like this.
No, no, I close, you cannot
say. They send all these things during the session, you know, so this is not necessary. We can start with this, what you prepare.
Yeah.
And I will just read about this. I will not talk too much because I prepare a lot of stuff. I need time for this, what I prepare. Anyway, they can read this, you know, this is no problem. It will be with them.
Right.
Okay. How are you?
Not good.
Tired. Why this why he didn't help you?
Oops.
He can help you also over this computer and too much for you.
Which we can start off, I think.
We can start, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. So good evening to everyone. Hope you are in same condition like last week when we was together. Again, thanks to Sports Authority of India and the Basketball Federation that they can give us this chance to share our experience, first of all, with the Indian coaches. I know that is a lot of different level of coaches, so Coach Matic and we and me, we was talking about this, and we will try to give to everyone what is important, you know. So the coaches for this grassroots, and also for these coaches with experience and who is coaching of senior teams, men's and women's. So. This is very good, you know, this is very good that really we can talk a lot of about basketball. Coach Matic yesterday made nice session with this modern basketball, also with this playbook. But what I want to tell you, as he was talking yesterday, you need to prepare simple, you know, what coach showed yesterday, this is really for high level, and it's very useful for national teams, senior teams, you know, and of course, you know, for this NBA level, I mean high level basketball. So it means that you need really good stuff, you know, with lot of assistance for video analyze, for strength and conditioning, for different position. So it's a little bit difficult for not only this grassroots. Hello.
Yeah, hello? Coach. Yeah, you can speak, coach. Everybody is.
But you tell me to join.
No. You are there. It's earlier. You can start.
Okay. So again, this technical problem, which make me nervous, because as I said before, I'm not such as good in this part. So this is normal according to my age. But I'm very happy that this new technology. I fight with this new technology almost once from early beginning, but finally. It help us a lot of, with one click we are together. So, okay. By the way, also I want to mention our logistics Coach Matic and me really have full support and full help from, first of all, Ankush and our referee, Rakesh. They help us really a lot of to prepare and to be ready to share with you this topics. Today, my topic is practicing this position five, actually, big players. According to this topic, we prepare this, Ankush prepare this concept, you know, and this concept you will see. What I prepare, as usually, I will carefully make selection of this topic, actually of this clinics, and I will share with you this video. So because of that, it helped me and it will help you, of course, you know, because it's much easier when you see on the court how it's going on. So today, because my topic is position five and how to practice this players, I choose one basketball clinic from Belgrade, from my country, and our famous players on this position, one of them is my ex-student in first division men's team. So you will exactly see without, because this clinic is on Serbian language, but doesn't matter, you know, as I tell you from early beginning, our job is our profession is copy paste, so it can be much easier to when you see this, even you don't know language, you know, you will see a lot of today is a much better situation because, you know, there is a lot of this internet possibility to see exactly what you want. On our time, Coach Matic and me, it was really very difficult. We was very hungry of knowledge, and our friends who knows who in that moment English language, they took something from America when somebody go over there, and then they some material they translate, and then we print this and share to our coaches. But today you have again one click and you can see everything. So this position five is today, especially in modern basketball, is very important position, and we need to know how to build post player. So first of all, again I will go back little bit in this grassroots. So this position need, you will be with the extreme players. I mean, their height will be extreme even when they are 15, 16, 17 years old. So they have predisposition to be on position five. So in that moment, you know, they are not, their fitness is not same like these small players. And also, their coordination is very weak. So you need a lot of time and a lot of patience to do with them. Especially what Coach Matic said, when we project this all-around players or multiple players, like Coach said, we need to from early beginning with these big guys or big girls to do the same drills, you know, same techniques like with these perimeter players. But in that moment, you know, their fitness, their coordination, because they still grow up, is very weak, and usually for non-experienced coaches, it's very difficult, you know, how to coaching these players. So usually, you know, that we don't care about these players, and because of that, later then we have lot of problems. So if I want to talk about how to build post players, first of all, I want to tell you that what we are looking, and all over the world, the people, clubs and then national teams, and who have this possibility to engage these foreign players, you know, all of them are looking position one and position five. So this is two positions which are more expensive in basketball. Their contracts is much bigger than all other players, especially players on position five. Before that, we was looking, you know, this position five to be strong, to be very, very tall. Then coach tell you what their size was dominate before. But now, you know, we are still looking for this same size, but these players must be, you know, more mobile and more with this ability, you know, this fitness and athleticism. So this is very, very important. What I want to tell you, this position before, nobody care about this players, you know, you this players was not it was not important to be intelligent. It was their job was very, very poor, you know, their role was very poor in basketball. They need to make some rebound on defense, to make some screen on offense, to do some offensive rebound, and that's it. And very, very often, all four players, you know, was waiting this position five men, you know, to reach other front court. So it was before, but now these players are very good athletes with very good running up and down, with very good transition offensively, defensively, with nice rebound, with a lot of their role is much richer now, you know. They're like we have perimeter players, we also need we call this inside playmaker. We have point guard, he's a perimeter point guard, and we have playmaker, actually, not point guard. And we have inside point guard. So this does mean that his role is very, very, very important, you know. What does mean inside point guard? But he do exactly what perimeter point guard do. He do exactly, but inside, nearby by basket. He can swing the ball from one side to other side. He can occupy his man if he's enough good to play one-on-one, you know, he can occupy other players and give a chance to his teammate to have more spacing and to have more good situation, you know. So that's why it's very important all teams to have, we call this inside game, you know, when we need to pass on this position almost every offense, almost 2-3 times we need to use these big guys. So on reverse pass, once when we exchange our position, you know, we will be in better situation because our D-men are going usually to help on this big guy. So that's why it's very important. Before, on my time and almost 10, 15 years ago, you know, to pass inside, it was almost every, I don't know, maybe sometimes 4 or 5 offense was that we didn't use our pivot man. So this is very important, you know, every offense, our ball need to go inside. And also on same time, we have to be ready, you know, for reverse ball and then to continue to play 2-on-2, you know, to use this players to play 2-on-2. Also, this role point guard, you know, inside point guard is very important. Once when you pass inside and after that you cut to the basket, you know, he will pass to you. There is a lot of our country was small country, but we was with 3-4 very good NBA level players, and they still, some of them are playing in NBA. Today, one of them is Nikola Jokic, national team player who is playing in NBA. And who is really like point guard. He have 2 meters, I don't know, 10, 15 centimeters, but he can pass a long pass. He can assist, you know, behind the back. He can assist around his head. He's amazing. He can shoot 3 points. He can do a lot of techniques under the basket, you know, in low post position. So this is, you know, what we have to talk about this position, how to build this post player. Of course, you will see on this video what I will share to you. You will see that they use, especially for warm up, they use, you know, ball handling drills when they play 1-on-0 full court. So all techniques they need to use. I'm talking now about this grassroots, you know, when they start. So no matter how big they are, you know, it's important they need to cross through all these techniques what we do with perimeter players. Many times Coach Matic and me, we repeat this. So about next, this footwork. I will not follow this, what you see in front of you. I want to give you more information. So this, what you see in front of you, you will use this, but now I don't want to read this and to repeat this and then to give my experience. I want to talk to you what is, of course, including this instruction what you have in front of you. I want to share with you my experience. So footwork, the most important for position 5 is their position, you know. So this position is very, very difficult, so that's why we need to use and to respect more this position 5 than we usually do. As I said previous, you know, 5 offense, we didn't pass no one time, and then we expect from these players when he received ball or where he took offensive rebound that he will easily score under the basket or something like this. This is wrong, you know. So he need to be involved in every single offense, you know. So to be active, and then you can expect from him that he will be, you know, on that he will do good his job. So because of this fighting for position, first of all, he's with the back to the basket, so he have, for example, the man on his shoulder and his back, who is almost laying on him before he received this ball. So he need to fight for this position, and usually what we make a mistake, because this perimeter players, they don't know exactly and how and on with timing to pass on this position. So because of that, I will suggest you to change, to switch this position, for example. 5 men to put on perimeter to see how it's difficult to pass on low post position, and 1 man to be on a low post position, you know, to see how it's difficult to fight for position and to catch the ball. So from time to time you can do this because it's very, very useful, you know. It's really difficult to pass with ball pressure, with everything, to pass in a moment when your teammate on low post position, when he make this good position to receive the ball. Once when he received this ball, first of all, I insist on 1 contact stop. While the ball is on air, he need to jump and to make 1 contact stop. So on same time on both legs. Why? Because he will use he will use both legs, you know, for next action, you know, for this pivoting and all other what he do. So this is very important. Teach them one when the ball is on air to jump and to stop on 1 contact, and of course to be very low. In a moment when he catch the ball, he need to be very low. He need to make immediately good body balance. Usually we used to say use these techniques or individual tactics to sit on defender leg. Let's say sit, you know. So defender is behind him. So he's on some diagonal stance or some according to this scouting individual what Coach Matic yesterday explained, you know. But now we are talking about in general, you know. So he need to sit on defender leg. So it does mean that he is enough low, that he is enough on good body balance. What can give him first of all opportunity to continue without violation. Usually, you know, they are with stretch legs, you know, and first of all, in this contact, the man a little push him, he lose body balance, and after that he make violation, you know, and he usually finish far from basket. Our intention is to be close to basket. So that's why one of the main for footwork is this stop on 1 contact. After that, with good, first of all, he need to control over his shoulder, to look, to watch all other players, 4 players, because sometimes he is with the back and he cannot see other part of the court. So he need to control this over his shoulder. He need to watch why this is important, because we use also this position 5 to swing the ball to other side or to create one-on-one. So once when he watch over shoulder, he will see where is his D-man, you know, on which side. If he is behind him, if he didn't close 1 side, I mean because of ball pressure, of pressure of passing line, you know, he will easier make a spin to find his man, and then he will continue. But before he continue, and this continuity is creating one-on-one, you know, and it does mean that he will use dribbling and all other things. He needs to make fake, you know. If he is with the back to the basket, he needs to fake 1 side and then to go to other side. So once when he saw position of his demon, he will continue, you know, to what we use. We use usually, you know, back pivot or front pivot, depend again of front demon. And then after that, you know, you fake, let's say, baseline, go in the middle. Fake middle, go on baseline. And then again, if you need to stop after one dribbling or two power dribbling, which can be used with back spin and on baseline, this counter, what we will talk later, you know, he need with two hands to make one dribble between his step. So this is because of protection, you know, he need to protect this ball. And why two hands? Because we call this power dribbling. So this dribbling give him impulse to jump after that, you know, and to jump high and to make a good layup. So this is, you know, very, very, very important. What we have? We have this usually, you know, when the ball are going around the arc, you know, around perimeter, we also want duck in. Duck in is truly basketball stance, you know, with the slide from one side to other side and fight for this position to receive this ball. Then we have this step back, you know, once when you make this pivot and face to the basket, you make one dribble and then step back and shoot. When we use this, when our D-man is too high, and if we continue, for sure it will be block shot. All other you will see on this, but what I tell you now, this is the most important. Also, whatever all this footwork, all motion must be again on basketball stance. It must be very low offensive basketball stance, you know. About violation, about these 3 seconds, because he's nearby paint, nearby 3 seconds area, I will suggest you, 3 seconds inside, count. Teach them to count, you know, once when they reach paint, to count. 1 and 2 and 3, and then go outside 1 second. And then again, fight for position, because if he go inside and stay too much, it will be violation, it will be 3 seconds, and we will lose the ball, but it's not good. About shoot, next, please. Again, whatever I'm talking now, you will exactly see on this video what I send you. This video is very useful, and as I said before, I careful make selection of this video, which can help you a lot of. And just one digression, you know. So whatever we send to you, please, you can use this step by step. Don't press them with too much, you know, this task, you know, with too much requiring. Just, you know, step by step, make two, especially on this position 5, it's very important that they can, you know, that you will teach them, let's say, 2 good techniques. Once when they make this excellent, you know, these techniques, you will go on other one. So, of course, you know, all these techniques can help them to be, you know, more dangerous for basket, but don't insist, you know, they need to know 10 techniques, you know, back pivot, front pivot, pull up jump shot, layup, spin, hook, semi hook, all these things, you know, up and down or reverse basket, all these things you can practice with them, but don't insist, you know, to be excellent in, once when they are excellent in 2-3 techniques of this shooting or this creating one-on-one, then you can easily go on next step and on next, and they will find their self, you know. They will see exactly what they are doing good. And even for opponent scout, you know, if they know that he is very strong in the middle of the paint with the semi-hook or something like that, it will be very difficult for them to stop him and very difficult to play defense on him. Even they know all his quality, you know, what is his strong side of game, you know, but it will be difficult. Okay, about shoot, you know, this is something special, you know, in this position. As I said before, we need also all our perimeter players to push them under the basket and to do the same techniques. And because of that, also our big guys need to take a shot, you know, like perimeter players. What I mean? I mean 3 points, you know, because I will talk about this later, about two on two or pick and roll or pick and pop, pick and slice, all this situation, you know, for pick and roll, pick and pop, you know, they are opening and they are took position, you know, for 3 points. So what does mean? It does mean that they must be able to shoot 3 points also. And for everyone, and especially for coaches, you know, who insist our big guys or girls to go under the basket only. No, why? First of all, they are higher. They are stronger than perimeter. They have a big hand, you know. So for them it's much easier to shoot 3 points than for small players, for sure. So that's why we don't need to stop them, especially, you know, when we use them in transition offense, when we have early pick and pop, let's say, or pick and roll, no matter, but pick and pop, they can be in situation to shoot this 3-point shoot like perimeter. So today, as Coach Matic said, in modern basketball, all 5 players need to know everything. So that's why I also insist our big girls to or players, you know, to practice 3-point shot. Of course, layup, jump shoot, the most important for them is, you know, to the short corner, because as I said before, you know, once when they start to create one-on-one, it's not only with the back to the basket, it's also with the face. And then read and react, you know, depend up to the man, they will create. They will shoot, they will decide to shoot, they will decide to make one dribbling and to go on layup or other things. Okay. So you will see also this on this my video what I share to you. Counter is a pivot that is used when it's initial pivot or shoot, definite. It should follow smoothly from the initial move into the counter because of his proximity to the basket. Counter moves are very effective for post players who don't have to finish with long short shots. They are done in close quarters, so they are quick and well often get your post player to the foul line. So this is something, you know, what I said before, you know, this low post position Also, our five men, it's not only on low post position, he's on high post position. So we have a lot of this game, you know, two on two. I mean, you know, this cooperation with our big players, you know, from high to pass to low post, also on cross screen, also on this situation. But according to this, you can also create this one on one and to create all this shoot. Okay, next one is positioning. Positioning, as I talked before, you know, this is very important. This is very, very, very important part of position five. Fight for position to receive this ball on time. You know, it must be both responsibility. It's very difficult, you know, on position five with the defense on your back, on your shoulder to fight. So you need to show your target where you can, your teammate from 45 degree or from the top, if it's post players on position four, on high post position, show your target where he will pass the ball to you. And also it's very important, you know, talking, you know, communication. So as you know, our point guard on the power forward or shooting guard, you know, he's under ball pressure. The men press too much this players, and it's very difficult, you know, to control this ball and on same time to be ready to pass on time on position five. So that's why, you know, sometimes very often you need to show your target and to ask ball, you know, because first of all, this is also with this psychological, you know, when you are asking for the ball, it does mean that you are ready for to receive this ball, and then you are ready to score or to make good job. So it give you confidence, and also it give your teammate who supposed to pass the ball to you that you are really, you know, that you really want this ball, and that you really he need to believe that if he pass to you that you will make good job. So this is, you know, complete problem, not only now on these topics. This is a complete problem, communication, you know, especially. Nobody knows the reason why players are not talking. Before practice, they are talking. After the practice, they are talking. But once when practice starts, they are mute. They are mute, complete, and they don't. So, very important. Please insist, especially this grassroots, you know, to talk. Offensively, defensively, no matter, just they need to talk. If he need to pass to him or she need to pass to her, pass, you know, ball. This is essential, you know, in all sports. So this positioning is also important, you know, once when we start to play, let's say this two on two. So why is important? Because it's important because of violation, you know. So if we want to play pick and roll or pick and pop or pick and slice, we need to do this on proper way. So you need to took position on the court where we decide to play this. It's middle pick and roll, as Coach Matić said yesterday. It's side pick and roll. It's on 60 degree. So there is exactly after this L cut, for example, if we want to play on 45, he will reach on free throws line, and then he will cut on sideline, you know, and take position for pick. So if he the pick and roll is two on two is both responsibility. Those one who set the pick and those one who use this pick, because this is something what you have to care if you play this pick. And Coach Matić said yesterday that is today. And the tendency and this revolution in modern basketball starts with many picks. You know, you need to do this on proper way. So if you move, if you are going out of your cylinder, you know, it's offensive foul. And especially now, they once when they want to clean basketball, you know, when they want to make less fouls, less contact, you know, it's very important. All six eyes, referees, are looking for this who is going out of his cylinder and make offensive foul, and they call immediately. No chance not to call. So that's why, you know, first of all, communication, verbal or with some sign. For example, when we put the ball between our legs on perimeter, it does mean big guy to come and to play pick and roll. So this big guy or big girl, she will show her fist, you know, and come to set the pick. And it must fly. This must fly. You know, he cannot jog, you know, easy to go. He must fly. So usually we pass inside and then outlet pass, and then after that he continue to play pick and roll. What we want from pick and roll? We want, you know, according to this good screen, five men, what he make, we want to make two on one. So from two on two, we want to make two on one. What does mean? This big girl or guy, he need to lock my player. If I call him on pick, you know, he need to lock my player. So he need to be strong, he need to be low, he need to be, because defensive player, they will kick them. And if he is not on good body balance, or she is not on good body balance, it will be, you know, he will be late on this pass, and it cannot be, you know, successful. So, of course, you know, this pick and roll. So you have, after this pick, you have this roll with back pivot, with face to the basket. If it's pop, you know, you have with the front pivot or back pivot also to receive this ball. Again, this footwork, what we were seeing from early beginning, all action must be low. Insist, again, I insist to you, you will insist to your students, you know, to be low, to be low. So this is about this positioning, especially, you know, on low post, this ducking, you know, this sitting on defensive players, and all these things. About this mental aspect, as I tell you, it starts from grassroots, you know, once when it's still not specialization, we need, you know, to support, because this big girl or big boy in this grassroots, you know, they're out of their their coordination, they're out of their fitness, they are not strong, such a strong, you know. So they need more attention and they need more focus to do this, you know. So as I said before, depends how much we use this position five, you know, how often they are in touch with the ball and they take a part on each offense, you know. It depends, it will be their game, their success will be, more useful, you know. They will be more useful, they will be more successful. So, again, very difficult, you know. They need to be smart, they need to read the defense, they need to react on time, they need to very intelligent players. So, especially, you know, when we on some level, when we have enough time to, when we are in club, when we have a season, full season, we are looking for tandems, you know. And usually when we are play away, where we are on camp, we usually, you know, put on same room position one, position five, for example, you know, and they are talking, they are different position, and they usually need somebody, you know, to there is not too much leader on this position, you know. I mean leader of the team. It's usually, you know, position one, position two, three, but five very, very rare. Because, you know, they are very, very important, you know, but usually they are not leader. So they need complete supporting. First of all, they need respect for them, their teammates, to believe them, to you know, to support them, not to everybody make mistake, but usually, you know, once when this big guy close to basket make mistake, everybody see this, you know. But when perimeter players make mistake, 100 mistakes, nobody judge this, you know. So usually, you know, how you miss under the basket, it's, you know. So this is very, again, very important position, you know, very, very much used today in basketball, offensively, defensively. There is some post move, you will see this later, you know. I was talking about this, it's difficult to show you in that condition, but you will see there is some drills, and the most important what I share to you, what Ankush will send to you, this video, you will see exactly all this post move, drop step, baseline, drop step, step middle, you know, you will see this. Now it's maybe it's not to waste the time on this. You will see also what Ankush prepared. There is some drills from Duke University with the nice coach Mike Krzyzewski. Now you will see this some chair drills, you know, when players are going from one side to other side with the back to the basket and make a spin, pivot, and then make a layup. So, you know, and I'm not sure yesterday coach, no, I think I you will see one drill when you have combined this, you know, when you have short corner, when you have duck in, when you have elbow, when you have pick on side, when you have, you know, so you can use this drills also for conditioning, you know. It's very nice. So one player do five spots, and then, you know, and as Coach Matic said, you know, these perimeter players, what they shoot every day, also these big girls, big guys, they need to make every single day on warm up, they need to make some set of shooting, you know, with layup, with the back, with the sorry. So you will see this again on this video, what I shared to you. Okay, let's go next. Split pose chair. So you can split this chair, you know, on low pose, high pose. You can one side, other side, and you can create whatever you want with different kind of shooting. You know, this hook, jump hook, it was very good, you know, when you put your body between ball and D-man. So it's maximum protection, and coach said yesterday that, you know, this is a more safe shoot than nobody can play defense, especially these small players, you know, when they use this, it's against big players, I mean, on same position, position five, it's very useful. But I want also to tell you, and today I don't know why, because of NBA for sure, and this is our we are guilty for this. We coaches are guilty. I don't know. There is this softball and there is basketball. I think the difference softball and basketball is board. So softball they have no board, and we have board. Why we have board? I don't know. Why we have board if we are not used this board? So today nobody use shooting from board. This is very, very strange, you know, but especially this position, they must use more board, you know. Okay, even when they are in short corner, when they are on zero, they cannot use this drill. But, you know, this short corner post drill, you know, this is also very, very good. This is their position. They need to close eyes and to score from this position. Also, they need to react, you know, to do what the defense wants to do. They need to do what they want to do on offense. So do everything before you start to dribbling. First of all, you cannot dribble too much. Teach them only one dribbling with one hand or with two power dribbling with two hands between the legs, you know, when they make backspin parallel with the baseline, but not to make too much dribbling. First of all, this position, you know, today in modern basketball, and very often you will see this, except we play zone defense, what is really really, it can kill our basketball in India, this zone defense. You know, on man-to-man, this position five, they usually don't play one-on-one. They play one against two. So you must teach them how to play one against two. Once if he, when he receive ball or she receive ball and make one dribbling and start to dribbling, it's end of the story. It's end of the day. It's turnover. You know, for sure losing ball. Why? Because, you know, first of all, it's high dribbling. Second, you know, too much people. They are going inside. They're going to help. Some teams, they play on man-to-man defense. They play trap, you know, they play double team. So if you use this dribbling for nothing, as I usually was talking before, you know, and then catch the ball, you are dead. You cannot do anything. So that's why, you know, they don't need to use too much dribbling. They need to know how to play. If they are playing floater, you know, in floater, in front of this perimeter player. Also, you know, don't use dribbling for nothing, this first dribbling. Use dribbling to create one-on-one. first of all, do everything, do fake one side, go to other side, or fake shooting and then go, or fake up and go down, or fake spin, but everything with one dribbling maximum. Even when you, when they create one-on-one from high post position, they must go with one dribbling on layup only, no two dribblings. Before, when I was talking about this perimeter players and this point guard, usually, no matter which level, we use three dribblings, you know, to go from one side to other side, from side to side. Three dribblings only. Even 15, 16 years old, they can make without violation three dribblings. So why you use five dribblings, you know, when you start to play 3-4 meters far from basket? That is nonsense. That is not necessary. Oh, okay, this is... this is from Duke. Nice coach, Mike Wyszewski. I'm not sure that he's this guy. You will see now this combination of shooting. You will see this low post, short corner, duck in, high post, side pick and roll. This is a nice combination. Okay, you watch this. I will tell you what you have on this video. What I want to share with you. You will see starting with warm up drill, then 1-on-0 full court with side dribbling, with stop and start, then 2-on-0 full court with the pick, then dribbling in paint floor, four players. You will see it's very nice drills. Then different kind of catching, teach them to catch in uncomfortable position, or give them pass, roll ball on the court, make high throw the ball high, and then he need or she need to jump and to catch this ball. You will see cutting. You will see different individual techniques and tactics. So. Practicing with these players, you know, you can make individual, you can make group practices also. Usually when it's a team practice, you know, these big players are on one side and other players on other side. Okay, I want to tell you a little bit about this, how we use also these big players. Of course, you know, this transition offense, you know, we can use them for early pick, you know, before defense took their position. We can use this big first of all first trailer, and usually, you know, I my five men, he is running his first trailer, and four men inbound the ball, and he or she is second trailer. So first trailer, you know, he cut to the basket, he took this, if it's possible to receive this ball to go on layup. So we need to practice this layup drill from full speed, game speed, then on low post, you know, then on this early pick, also we use these big players defensively, you know, on different kind of pick, you know, pick and roll. We use this big players to they play defense on pick with the drop, they play with hedge, they play with the double team, they play with the switch, you know, today position 5 to switch player on perimeter is no big problem, you know, this is not mismatch. 5 men with 1 man on perimeter, this is not mismatch. So they need, you know, to help and to recover. They don't need to too much to help because they leave their players and it's very difficult to do on transition defense, you know, because I was talking, they are running up and down without any problem. So when you are running back, you know, you need to run with some task. You cannot just anyway you are going back. But when you are going back, do something, you know, not just run to the middle and then turn around and then looking where is player. No, he must be also busy like all other players. Especially in this young category, you know, this from 15 to 19, when we are play very aggressive defense and all this, you know, they must be useful, they must help, you know. We call this level. I will touch this once when I will talk about defense. I will touch this, what does mean level. If my man is... I'm going on defense. I'm talking now about defense and transition on defense. If my man is under the basket over there and the ball is in the middle of the court, I will not looking for my man over there. He's not on offense. He or she is on defense because she's or he is behind the ball. So I will be in a level with the ball, you know, and help my teammate once when for example, when offensive player beat them, to be ready to beat tandem, you know, to protect his back, and he need to know that I am ready to help. This is very important, you know, and of course, you know, open position, and then you can match your player, and then you can play. But be ready to help all the time, during all single game, you know. Any questions? I think that according to this, what Ankush prepare and what I will send to you this video and this my experience, I hope it can help a little bit to you, you know, to improve your thinking about position 5. Thank you so much.
Any questions can raise their hands.
God bless you. Stay safe and take care.
Kirupa, you can ask your question.
But no difficult question, please. I'm joking.
You can ask your question, Eugene Basketball.
Good evening. It was nice. Being part of this wonderful session. I would like to have all the PowerPoint presentation of this because the Zoom is not so good to understand much of the session happening in the session.
So we have already sent in the chat the links and the video links. You can...
No, with what I haven't received anything.
In the chat...
Yeah, is it Ankush?
Yeah. In the chat, we have put the link. You can download it from that link.
Okay. That's fine. Other than that, you know, everything is fantastic. And thank you, Coach,
You're welcome.
Being a wonderful person and And also, I have sent a mail ID. I would like to share anything is there, if at all, if I miss something. And I will be thankful to you.
Of course. You can be in touch with our nice Ankush, who really do great job. Without him, we cannot do anything, for sure. And sorry again, if you have any technical issue, just please understand this situation, because this is the best what we can do in this moment. Thanks God we can be again together, we can be on court, it will be everything much easier. Because, you know, really BFI Ankush, what he do, and Coach Matic and me, it's the best what we can do in this moment. So please understand this. If you have any problem, we can try to fix this problem. Thank you.
Raj, you want to ask any questions? Digvijay, you want to ask question, you can ask. Hello. Coach, don't think there's a question, so we can use it.
No question. Okay. So once again, thank you. Thank you so much to everyone. I think tomorrow, Ankush will give you information. Tomorrow is our referee. They will give us also very, very interesting and very useful information. And we can talk about this. I think Coach Matic will coordinate tomorrow. I will coordinate Saturday. And also, see you again. Take care, stay safe. Thank you, Ankush.